If you're suffering from pain associated with an L4-L5 disc bulge or L5-S1 disc bulge, or even a disc herniation or disc protrusion in the lower lumbar spine, and you're wondering, when should you start exercising? Is it at the onset of the symptoms or later on? That's a great question that I'm going to answer in this episode of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro. It was asked by one of the followers and subscribers of my channel. And this is something that's very important, because when my patients come into my office and they have early onset of symptoms, severe symptoms, serious symptoms, pain, and lots of mobility limitation, I do not start them on exercises right away. We wait until the pain is subsiding. So that's very, very important. There is no way, when there's a hot disc, an inflamed disc, and zapping pain on the leg, that anyone can actually begin to do any type of exercise to handle that. Now, at best, I may tell someone to at least not be sedentary all the time. So get some mobility in terms of walking, right? Walk around the house, not to be a little bit mobile, to tolerance, but there's really no exercise that we get into. Now, it will depend on when the patient is ready, but usually it's when the pain and symptoms begin to subside, you know, anywhere from 20, 30, or 40% less. And the first thing I start with is mobility exercises, like a seated pelvic tilt or a cat camel exercise. Get the lower lumbar spine moving a bit. Then once the pain is more subsided, you know, maybe 70 or 80%, then I'll start getting into some strengthening and stretching exercises. So some stretching, some maybe sciatic and nerve floss if you have leg pain, some bird dog or side planks, or other planks, a dead bug, things that will stabilize the lower lumbar spine and back, okay? So the whole point of the story is that you don't start exercises when there's serious, severe pain. It's just not gonna be comfortable, not gonna be tolerable. Always do exercises when it's tolerable to you and at the appropriate time and under the guidance of your health professional. So if you enjoyed this answer in this episode of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro and you wanna see more of these type of videos, go ahead right here and watch this playlist over here to get more episodes of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro.